Okay, so what I'd like to do now is, in order to start showing how we find the minimum arborescence on a directed graph, I'm going to start by finding the minimum arborescence on a directed graph that has no cycles. So this is my graph G. G has no cycles. That's important because when we actually do the minimum arborescence on a directed graph, there may very well be cycles. So, but this is the first step to explaining it. Okay, so you can see in this graph that I have some nodes that have more than one edge entering them. So specifically, D, E, and F have more than one edge entering them. So what I do is I'm going to create a modified graph. Okay, and in this modified graph, the only thing that will be modified will be the weights on the edges. And the way I modify it is for every vertex not equal to the root, find the edge that has the minimum cost. YV equals the minimum cost entering edge. And then when you find that, from every edge entering V, subtract YV, and that will form the new edge in my modified graph. Then, for every entering edge, V, subtract the minimum cost from the original cost. So entering edge, we'll call that edge E, from the original cost. Okay, so in the case of this graph, let me go ahead and do that. A is my root, so there's nothing to do there. I have edge B. Edge B has only one edge entering. It's this one, AB. So the minimum cost for that will be 10. So I subtract 10 from the cost of all edges entering B, and so that will give me the new edge weight of 0 right here. And so you can see that every single node will have at least one edge entering it with new cost 0. Okay, so let's look at D. D has two edges entering, 1 and 2, so I subtract 1 from all those edges. So that will give me 0. Whoops. Oh, heck. Let's fix that. Right, I'm looking at D here. There's my D. So from my C, I will have 0. It's my new cost. And then from A, I will have 1 as my new cost. A to C is analogous to A to B. There's only one entering edge there. So A to C has new cost 0. E has two entering edges. Minimum cost is the 2. So that will now have, I'm talking about vertex E. B to E will have cost 0, and D to E will have cost 1. 3 minus 2 is 1. For F, I've got two edges, 4 and 8. Subtract 4 from both of those, so B to F will have weight 0, and C to F will have weight 4. Okay, now the next step in the algorithm is for each vertex, V not equal to R, choose one 0 cost edge. Because I have no cycles in my initial graph, the new graph that I get will be an arborescence. So for example, on this graph right here, I will end up with exactly one arborescence because all my vertexes have only one incoming edge that has a 0 on it. So let me start. Of course, I have to start with the root. That's not included in here, but I have to start with the root. So I choose the root. And now to be the edge that I will pick will be the 0 cost edge. That happens to be from the root. And then to, let's say, F, the cost will be there's only one, so that's this F, B to F. Okay, To the D, there's only one zero cost. That's this one right here from C to D. Okay, to the E, there is one zero cost. That's from B to E. And to C, there's only one zero cost. That's A to C. Okay, so I have all my vertexes here. My original costs, let me write them up there so that we can see them. These are the original costs. Let's see, this is 1, 2 here, and 4. So with my original cost put back, I've got a cost of 21, 23, 27.